Hi everyone, today we will talk about Delta DIAEnergie basic. You can see the system architecture. Basically, here we don't need the personal data, but because it's just easier for me. So this video, I will show you use my laptop connect to IPC, and this IPC will install the DIAEnergie software to gather the data from Delta POC and power meter. And you may wonder what is this. This one is actually the gateway. You will convert from the Ethernet to RJ45 to access the data from power meter. Okay, and you can see the POC IP address is 192.168.1.5, and gateway will be 0.1.10. And how to set up the IP address of gateway and the protocol for IS485. So you can do this setting from DCI shop. Okay, so please remember to install the DCI shop. And here remember to switch this one to Ethernet. And as I mentioned, because I use a RJ45 port link with a POC and power meter. Okay, after that we can click here to search. Okay, and here you can see this is a DVP SE. You can also modify the IP address from here. Okay, second would be the gateway IFD 9506. So again, we can define the IP over here, and then we can define the COM2 because the COM2 is for IS485 and COM1 is for IS232. Okay, and here we define the protocol as N2 ASCII. And remember, this is this setting should follow your dip switch on the IFD gateway. And of course, here should follow this protocol should be exactly same as what you do in the power meter setting. Okay. After that, how to log in DIAEnergie. You can see here we have to enter the IP address 127.0.0.1, and the default is a root admin. After you log in, then you will see these 11 items. And as I mentioned, it's a root and admin. Okay, so first of all, we will do the user management setting. So user management setting is basically up to your customer, how many group they want to separate. So basically, if you log in with a root admin, then that means it's an administration. Okay, so you can add on engineer, manager, and operator. After you add on the authority group, then you can add on a specific user for different group. Okay, so here it already exists for the admin, and we can add on for the engineer first. So for engineer, you might allow him to do the topology and the device tag mapping. And of course, you can open more function for engineer. And we can add on the manager. And for manager, basically they just want to see the results. So I think no need to open the set function for managers. Okay, as you see here, we'll pop up the factory setting because if we enable the energy dashboard, then we have to enable the function for factory setting and the hierarchy. Okay, then we can add on operator also for the hierarchy. Then this one, I think we just enable a preview for operator. Okay, so here we can add on a different group. Okay, and here you definitely can define a different account. For example, okay, so here you can see I define I4 as administrator. I'm sorry. Should be add-on from here. It's my bad. Okay, and then we can add on another, like maybe facility guy. Okay, we give them just the operator. Okay. Okay, then I will show you that we log in with a different account. Okay, this one we log in with the facility, the operator. Okay, and then I change back to iPhone. Okay, because I defined the administrator. Okay, then we back to root admin. Okay, so next will be how to create the energy dashboard. So we might back here. Energy dashboard, we have to set up the hierarchy then be by sequence device topology and tag mapping. So here we will use an example letter delta and factory. And then we will create the device topology as we introduce on the top. We will add on one POC, one gateway, and one power meter. Okay. So here we will add on a rocket name is Delta. And it would be the factory. And here you can define based on your company or your customer real situation. For example, here we use the 2000. And click enable. And you can also define the conversion coefficient. Okay, so next step we go to device topology. Then we can create add. Okay, and let's find the control device. We can find one Delta POC. So we can define this one. For example, it's for the control for first floor. And we can define the POC is for DBPSE. Channel will be based on this one. And we define the IP address. Okay. And then we add on a field device gateway. And we can define this as a gateway. Then we select the same channel because it will link with a server with the Ethernet. And we define the IP address. After that, because we use IS485 link with a power meter. So here, as I mentioned, remember change to 0.2. And this one we define IS485. We define in ASCII 9 non 2. Okay, and we can add on one delta power meter. Okay, again the channel, that means from which network you connect to the upper device. Okay, so now we already finished the device topology setting. Okay, so next step we have to configure the tag mapping. So here, just to let you know, later we will use a DVP, a real-time clock RTC from 1313 to 1319. So this one you can see today's 2021 May 22nd, and today is a Saturday. Okay, so you can see this device from DIAEnergie. Okay, so now we go to tag mapping. So here we can add on the data register. Okay, here you can also define the data type and whether this one you want to write or not. Or if you want to write the data, then you can click the writable. Here you will see if the status show the green light, that means the connection is okay. And you can see the value will be real-time update. Okay, so you can see this is the current time is 5 p.m. Okay, so we can also check the connection status over here. So you can click here to show the connection status. And then we will link to the power meter. For the power meter, it will be slightly different because we already add on this, so you can click face new to add on all. And you can also click here to check the connection status, and also if you want to monitor some energy tech information, you can also click here. Okay. Okay, then we can back to here. So next we will select the source configuration. So we can click the overview, and later we will add on two display. One is indicate for the timer from PLC. Another is a power meter. But I have to say sorry that because the power meter I use for this demo have some issue, so it cannot show properly. Okay, then we can go to the UI design. Okay, sorry, my bad. Here, we should go source configure. And then we have to create the page. And we can, okay. Then we can go to our UI design. Okay, so here you can see what pop up. These pages. Okay, then as I mentioned earlier, here we will show you the POC RTC a second. And we will also show the power meter, but I have to say sorry that because this power meter has some issue, so I think cannot show the function properly today. But just let you know how to do this, okay? Okay, then we click here to see the click a preview. So then you can see this one is the timer from PLC, and this one is the power meter. But as I mentioned, because some issues, so we cannot see the function properly. Okay, so that's all for today. Thank you.